Okay, so today we're going to share about what's the difference between indigestion, bloating, and belly fat. Okay, both are about having the stomach to be a bit rounder. Okay, so there is definitely ways to differentiate it. So for indigestion, bloating, okay, basically the bloating itself can happen rapidly and can also resolve just as quickly. However, for belly fat, okay, it doesn't greatly increase as a result of one meal or even a day's worth of meals, right? So it's the speed of the creation of the bloating or the roundedness in the stomach, okay, that will differentiate between indigestion, bloating, and belly fat. Okay, so that is the main one. And also, there is another thing is that one easier way to look at it is also that for belly fat itself, you can actually physically grasp the belly fat with your hand. So this is what we do for the fat pinch test. Okay, so we can use a pincer, okay, to actually just pinch on the belly fat area and see how much fats you have at the belly area. So you can actually physically grasp the belly fat with your hand on the pincer. Okay, but for indigestion bloating, you can't do that, okay, because the kind of bloating, okay, is not coming from the fats itself. It's actually coming from internal increase in the air that is accumulated within the stomach. All right, so these are the two main factors, okay, that can help us to differentiate between belly fat and indigestion bloating. And I'm going to share something extra with my other Platinum group and Facebook live stream group. Yep, so this week will be that's about it. All right, so if people, okay, for some people they may think like, oh, it may be fat or it can be bloating. Okay, the person that is experienced the bloating should feel some differences in terms of discomfort within the belly itself. But for belly fat, okay, the belly fat is always there, so you can't how to say, you can't feel the discomfort. Okay, no matter what, the belly fat is always there. But bloating wise, okay, the person should feel some differences within the body. That is a lot of discomfort or belching, okay, or pain. All right, so that is the difference. 好，那之后呢，我们会分享关于就是消化不良的胀气和肚子的肥胖呢有什么不同。那第一个呢，就是说我们在消化不良所导致的胀气的时候，还有那个肚子肥胖的时候呢，肚子都是圆圆的哦。那有时候人家就不能分别，就是是胀气呢，还是变肥了。好，那以下呢就是几个点，就是分别胀气跟肥胖。哦，在肚子那里的不同。那第一个呢，就是胃胀气呢，它是可以在短时间内或者餐后呢就造成的。那它产生的很快，然后消下去的也很快。可是呢，肚子的肥胖呢就不是这样，它不是因为一餐所导致的肚子的变得比较大，比较圆哦。是吧？是，它是经过了一段时间，才有这样的肚子比较大的那个情况所以就是这样，就是看胀气呢，它有一个时间它来得快，去得也快。然后呢，另外一个就是什么呢？另外一个就是肚子的肥胖呢，我们可以用我们的手去抓住那个肥胖的部分这个是我们在看减肥需要减肥的病人的时候呢，就是看他的那个 肚子的脂肪啊有没有很多的时候，我们是用这样的一种方式来测量有多少脂肪哦。所以肚子的肥胖呢是可以用这样的方式，用手可以夹住的。可是如果是胃胀气呢，你就无法用你的手呢去夹那个肚子哦，因为有时候可能很瘦的人他也是会有胃胀气呀，所以就无法用手呢，还是用什么仪器呢去抓住那个肚子的那个脂肪哦。好，那就是这样了。然后其他的点呢，我就会跟我的另外Platinum Group 还有我的 Facebook 的 Stream Group 那里分享咯。所以很多人可能会觉得胃胀气啊，有时候他自己也不知道是胃胀气还是肥胖，但如果你胃胀气的时候呢，那肯定会伴随着不适感或者疼痛啊，或者嗳气吞酸啊这种的不适感哦。那肚子的肥胖你可能就是一直在肥胖的状态中，也不会有什么就是不适感哦，除非你的胃里面就是有很多的胃酸啊，还是消化很差的时候呢，同时你有肥胖又有胃胀气，那可能你肚子就会变得很圆哦。好，那大部分人就是这样。好啦，那这周的分享就是先这样喽。